Welcome back, everyone. What a beautiful day in Houston. There's a look over Centennial Gardens and Herman Park. So, folks, a lot of us suffer from sinus issues, and if your sinus symptoms are always giving you trouble, it could be something much more serious. Dr. Robert Palmer with American Sinus Institute is here with details on a procedure that could help. And by the way, this procedure, you guys do more of this procedure than anyone in the state of Texas, right?
That's true.
Okay, so when someone is experiencing sinus issues, and we've had you on the show before, but I think it's worth underscoring because so many people suffer from sinus issues, when do you know there's actually a problem?
I think it becomes repetitive. So you may have a sinus infection once or twice in your life and no big deal.
Right.
It's when you start having symptoms every 3 to 4 times a year. And then it takes several weeks for it to go away. And it could be the result of allergies that cause a sinus infection. And so as a result, you're constantly going to the doctor, constantly going on antibiotics. That's when it becomes an issue.
Well, we've got some of these symptoms on the screen right now. I was just reading through the list during the break. I was surprised that sore throat and bad breath are symptoms.
Exactly, because sometimes the drainage goes down the back of your throat, and when it does, it can cause an irritation so you can get a sore throat, and then also can cause an infection in your tonsils, and as a result can cause bad breath. But in and of itself, recurring sinus infections can cause bad breath as well.
Interesting. So, and for a lot of people, Dr. Palmer, these symptoms are more than just an annoyance. They're really preventing them from...
It's a quality of life
quality
issue.
Quality of life, right?
Exactly.
Okay, so how do we fix the problem?
We fix the problem by first giving them some antibiotics to get rid of the infection, knowing that if we don't do anything else, it's probably going to come back, and also addressing their allergies. But most of it's a ventilation problem. So the little sinuses have to have ventilation. And that's why the balloonplasty has become so successful. We don't surgically open them, we dilate them without causing trauma. So now the sinus ventilates properly, doesn't have a pressure issue, and they drain and ventilate. That reduces the number of infections you'll have.
And is this animation that we're seeing now, is this the Onrubia technique that you've told us about before?
Well, exactly. I mean, the balloonplasty is one aspect of his technique.
Okay.
His technique addresses the sinuses by dilating all the ostia, but we also treat the nasal passages to cause them to let airflow better and not obstruct those ostia in the future.
Well, and also what I think is incredible, because we've heard from a number of patients who have had this procedure performed on them, the recovery time here it's so minimal.
Oh, it's so much better than sinus surgery. Sinus surgery, you had packs anywhere from 3 to 5 days, and you had issues for 2 to 3 weeks to 4 weeks. This operation, you're feeling pretty good the next day.
And by packs, you mean packs like?
Packs in your nose.
Packs.
No packs with us.
So people are not, when they have this procedure done, they're not experiencing any of this discomfort?
No, they have a little discomfort. We give them a little bit of pain medication for about 24 hours. That's about all they needed.
And then it's back to life.
Yeah, and if they don't have a job that requires heavy lifting, they can essentially go back to work the next day if they have a desk job.
That is incredible. Okay, so let's say someone thinks that they might have a problem or they want to get looked at. How does it all work? They come in and they sit down with you guys and get a consultation?
Yes, they set up an appointment and we do a history and physical and we do a CT scan. And between the CT scan and the history and physical, we make a decision if they would benefit from the procedure.
Okay, got it. And I understand you guys are doing something new as well. You're also doing allergy testing?
Exactly. That goes hand in hand with sinuses. Most people who have recurring problems with their sinuses have underlying allergies that contribute to it. So what I've found, most people who have allergies and have recurring infections, when you do the balloonplasty, they now live with it very well. They still have allergies. Some people don't even need to address it, but we found there's about 20% to 30% who have underlying allergies need to treat their allergies with probably immunotherapy. So we do skin testing, and if they have allergies that are significant enough, then we recommend sublingual therapy rather than shots.
So sublingual therapy, does that mean like an allergy drop?
It's an allergy drop.
So easy.
The floor of your mouth, and it's absorbed, and it builds up an immunity to the allergens that you're allergic to.
And what is the skin test entail? Because you guys, as I understand, you can test for a number of different allergies, like a bunch, right?
Oh, a bunch, yeah. And so it's a prick test. You take the antigen and put a little prick in the skin, and if you're allergic to it, it gets to a certain size and you document that. And we do that within 45 minutes, we have the answer.
Got it. So it's a minor test.
Minor test.
Minor discomfort, but people who have been wondering why they've been having these issues for a long time, they can identify the problem.
Exactly.
Right there. Okay, we're almost out of time, but very quickly, there are other places that do this procedure. Why should people come to American Sinus Institute?
Because that's all we do. That's all I do. I do the balloonplasty and the Rubio technique exclusively. And so we do a large number of them over and over and over again. And like everything, the more you do, the more efficient you get.
That's true.
Okay.
Dr. Palmer, great to see you. Thanks for coming by.
You bet. Thank
you. We'll see you again.
All right.
And folks, if you would like more information about this procedure, you can call 713-BALLOON, which works out to be 713-225-5666. You can also visit AmericanSinus.com. All right, folks, coming up after the break.